When I was looking at today's topic, there were two parts to it, employability and skills. Okay, I returned to Bangalore from the Middle East about 7 years ago. And when I came back, I wasn't sure what I wanted to do here. And I was a little bit worried about what I'd do next. So I was speaking to a friend of mine from Bangalore, and he said, okay, you're coming back and you're not sure what you need to do. If you need a job, once you land in Bangalore airport, take a piece of paper. Write on that, I know SAP, stand outside, somebody will come in a car, pick you up and take you to their office. Okay. So we are in a market in Bangalore where employability is not so much of a dilemma or a problem, irrespective of the geography we service. Okay. We talk about skills. There's a focus today on individual skills that can get you into the US. Every country has a screening system. They don't need people who have skills that already exist in that country. That part has been covered. What I would like to talk about is, you've got there. What are the skills that you need to succeed? The skills that you need to succeed are not, it's not about Java, it's not about SAP, whether you're in financials, it's not about Oracle. What is it? When you're working in a global environment, the days of monolithic delivery is over. Okay, whatever work that you do, whether it's in the US or in any other country, you will be working across at least 2 or 3 geographical locations, your team. Okay, and most of this interaction will happen over video conferencing, it will happen over the phone, etc. So a very important skill that I focus on, but which I find that people don't really give much importance to, is what I call cultural acclimatization. You need to be able to develop a skill that allows you to work with people in different geographies, with different working styles, different time zones. It may sound very basic, but if you look at it, service delivery fails more because of such factors when you're doing complex projects rather than necessarily the quality of code. Delivery, service delivery in IT has matured to a level where there are inbuilt checks and balances as far as technical work goes. It's very difficult for you to get something out and push it to production that will cause it to fail because there are 3 people checking what you do. But it's very easy for you to speak to somebody and pass on a design that is disastrous. Okay, because it meets the specs, it'll go, it won't work. So culturally, we need to be able to work on our communication. This is the single biggest hurdle that is preventing effective delivery. We've got the technology part, we've got the model part. People need to move up to this level of working because the nature of delivery is complicated. Okay. This cannot be taught. We've talked about the education system, we've talked about, unless the education system becomes far more multicultural and open, more liberal, okay, this is not going to happen with a syllabus-based education system, which is 90% of the engineering that we have in India. Okay. So when we talk about, yes, all of you have thought about the skills that are required to go to the US or whatever geography you choose to go, but it's very important also to keep in mind what you need in terms of being able to succeed there. So I would strongly urge that there is a focus on the ability to get to work with different cultures, understand that communication is a very important part of these. The soft skills are as important as the technical skills as you move forward. Thanks.